Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging hour discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cucchiara, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management.
Live real estate radio show related in the Bay Area. Coming to you Monday through Friday from 3 to 4 here. And a couple different ways you can listen to the show. One is on your radio at KDOW 1220 AM. We are the Wall Street Business Network station here in the Bay Area. And you could also listen to us live online if you go to KDOW.biz. That's KDOW.biz. But we'd also love you, most importantly, to download the podcast, follow the show anywhere. You could do that at iTunes, Stitcher, all the different locations. You could also go to our website at reradiolive.com. That is reradiolive.com, and download the podcast and listen to the show anywhere and everywhere you can. Most of you, if you've been listening to the show for the last 4.5 years now, the focus has always been the same. That is education information. We have great guests like today I'll introduce in just a moment. Great content, good information to keep you advised. The focus is to educate and inform you, the consumer, to help you make wise decisions in and around your real estate transactions. So we will continue to do that for sure. And I'm excited today to invite our guest, for the entire hour. And she is calling in from New York. We're going to hear a lot about the New York market and some international markets and a bit of much more. So I want to invite her in, Jacky Teplitzky. She is the associated real estate broker and a team along with the Douglas Elliman real estate firm in New York. Jacky, how are you doing today?
Fine, thank you, especially in this beautiful spring day in New York.
So you guys are having beautiful weather as well then?
Yes, exactly. We are in the 50s, and last week we were like minus one. So, you know, so we would definitely welcome the weather.
Well, it's great to have you on, and I'm excited about the show. It's always great to have information on real estate, really, in different areas, not only in the United States, but international. And this is so much of an economic global market that we live in today, and real estate certainly part of that. So thanks for spending the time. Maybe we could get started, Jacky. You could tell the listeners a little bit about you, your background, and what your current roles and responsibilities are there out in New York City.
So I basically had the Jacky Teplitzky team in New York and Miami. And since you mentioned international, I have myself, I have a very international background. I was born in Santiago, Chile. I was raised in Israel. And then I worked in Europe. And I came to the United States. So my background in real estate is also from a cultural point of view, you know, of how to work with the foreign market, in understanding the intricacies of each person's background. And I work in New York and Miami because a lot of my clientele is from Latin America, and they primarily buy real estate in Miami and New York.
Yeah, very good. So what, you know, most of you guys are probably experiencing a similar market, but it would be nice for our listeners here just to kind of give you a quick overview. You probably know you follow the real estate market closer than anybody and you understand it. But out here, you know, the business economy is so strong. Prices continue to go up and there's just no more places to build really in the Silicon Valley and just south of San Francisco where we are. Strong business market. Silicon Valley is thriving and, there's very, very little inventory. So, you know, it's really a this little economic, you know, market going on over here, and it's hard to really understand sometimes what the rest of the United States is doing in other areas because of the area we live in. Maybe you could give the listeners a little bit of a taste of the kind of the New York market and what are you guys experiencing, what's really going on in that marketplace right now as we sit here today and roll into 2016.
Well, what you just described about, you know, Silicon Valley is something that we experienced last year, at the beginning of last year, 2015. But now entering into 2016, we're actually seeing a stabilization of the market. We do not predict that we are going to have major price increases. I actually think that we are going into a market correction. And here the issue about inventory has been that a lot has been built in the very, very high end of the market. And for us, the high end of the market will be above $10 million. And there has been, you know, a group of buildings that have been constructed in the last 3 years that already came to the market, and you have in the pipeline more product in the very, you know, ultra-luxury market, which I think that eventually is going to, you know, have some sort of a correction. Between the 1 million and 3 million is still robust, but it's not crazy. Mm-hmm. Last year, you know, we were having bidding wars in almost every single apartment if it was priced anywhere between 1 and 3. Now we are seeing a normal market, not a crazy market. And between the 3 and the 5, I would say that, between the 3 and the $10 million market, we are seeing a little bit of a slower pace. And so there is a little bit of, people are more cautious in their decisions, and we think that the reason for that, we are very linked to the stock market here. You know, Wall Street and real estate are very, they go hand in hand, and because, as you know, the stock market in the beginning of the year, you know, was having a little bit of problems, so I think that it's also translated into the real estate market.
Yeah. You know, one of the things that's intriguing to me, Jackie, is that maybe you could speak to it just a couple minutes, is that when we hear about New York City, we think about high-rises and luxury apartments and all these beautiful places. But there is so much business out and around the suburbs and different places around New York City. What is the market like, you know, with the single-family home areas in and around your area, or do you get involved with that much, or what is that market like compared to maybe the New York City that a lot of people are focused on, which is the high-rise kind of luxury apartments and, you know, the robust city?
Well, we have to be careful also in that description. I mean, when we are talking about the island of Manhattan, you do have apartments that are $2 million, $1 million, $600,000. I do focus in the island of Manhattan. I do not work outside the city because that's a very different market. I can say that Brooklyn is definitely right now, you know, its own identity, and the Brooklyn prices are almost on par with the Manhattan prices. Queens is a very, very different area. Staten Island is a very different area. So you do have to be more, you know, specialized in the different areas. So the single family market is also doing well, but it's a complete different market driven by other factors, not so much, you know, like we are seeing in the Manhattan market.
Got it. Well, you are an expert in real estate. You speak, you coach, you're involved with many, many different organizations, seminars. I mean, you live this and breathe this. We talked earlier before we went on the air. You were asked to speak at the Elliman event, which is one of the big events here that I participated in, also in San Francisco last year. Tell us a little bit about, as you spoke last year, Jackie, in hindsight, how did 2015 kind of match up to your forecast?
So 2015 was an excellent year in all price categories. And, you know, we had very little inventory. We had, a lot of competition from buyers to get the right housing. And that, I think, lasted all throughout till after Labor Day. But then Labor Day came and, you know, there was a little bit of a slowdown in the market. And now, you know, we're entering what I call a more normal market, which is something that I actually like. And I, you know, I said to myself, well, we don't want to get into the bubble world, correct? Because that's like a bad word. So I feel that, you know, what we are seeing now is that we are not in a bubble, that we are, in a complete normal market. And in a normal market, an apartment takes between 3 to 6 months to sell. So 2015 was definitely a very good year for all of us. 2016, I feel that it's going to be a little bit slower. and maybe mm-hmm. we're not going to see a lot of big ticket sales like we saw in 2015. In 2015, we broke a lot of records in the very high end of the market.
Okay. If you're just tuning in, again, this is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We have on the phone calling us from New York is Jacky Teplitzky. Teplitzky, is that how you pronounce it?
Teplitzky.
Teplitzky, I'm sorry. Teplitzky. And she is a recognized real estate speaker, coach. She does a great job in really following this industry in general. And we are lucky enough to have her on to call for the entire hour to tell us a little bit about forecasting, what we expect in 2000, you know, some of the things she's looking at in 2016, and we're going to go into some other details as well. If you'd like to check in, if you have any questions for Jacky or me during the show, 1-800-516-1220 is the toll-free number, or you could text any questions in at 408-838-9060. We have just a couple minutes left in this first segment, Jacky, and we could start this, and then we come back on the next segment, we can continue. But most important housing market trends for, you know, what do you think will be the most important things as we sit here today and, you know, the first quarter of 16? What are you expecting to see and why?
I think that the market that is most robust right now is the one-bedroom market, like the starting apartments, and the reason for that is the very low interest rates. Even though the Fed, you know, raised the interest rates, but it didn't affect so much the mortgage rates. Mm-hmm. I think that we are going to see a little bit of a slower pace in the sales as far as volume. And whatever was overpriced from 2015 will have to have a price correction in the beginning of 2016.
And when you make those assessments, are you speaking about the economy in general, the housing market economy in general?
No, I'm specifically speaking about the market here in New York, just because.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah.
Yeah, just because in New York, you know, the prices went up very fast in the last 2 years, and basically the equation was that, you know, when you were pricing in 2015, you were taking as a comparable the last sale and then putting another 10% on it and then launching it to the market. So that 10% on top of the previous, I don't think it's going to work anymore.
Got it. All right, we're going to have to take our first break. When we come back, a call from New York. Our real estate expert is Jacky Teplitzky. She is she's kind enough to join us. She's a real estate expert, recognized speaker, coach, does a great job at really talking about forecasting the industry. We're talking about 2015, and now just before we took our first break, we were talking about 2016 and some of the trends she's seen specific to New York, the New York area, and why. Jacky, do you have, you're seeing in the New York market in general a maybe flattening or slowing down, or just, would that be kind of the overview for 2016 as you see it?
The problem is that we all thought a normal market is. So I think that we are just in a normal market,
yeah.
You know,
that's
and
a
we
good
have
point,
been
yeah.
You know, we have been spoiled, and basically, you know, we were used to the fact that everything that you put on the market, you know, in 1 or 2 weeks you get an offer and you have a deal.
Right.
So now it's just a normal market. I don't think that we are in a bad market, but we are just back to normal.
Yeah, back to normal. Mm-hmm. So what is that? Is there continued building, and if you give us a sense for New York, I know you're the Manhattan area, and maybe some, but in general, is there still plenty of room to for growth in the New York area in terms of the different city locations?
Yes, I mean, and that's actually, you know, why one of the reasons why we are going into a normal market, because we have new buildings that are coming, you know, to the market this year. And in addition to that, here we have a lot of what we call conversions, meaning, you know, buildings
yeah.
that were either office buildings, rental buildings
mm-hmm.
that are being converted to condominiums. So people have much more from what to choose. And they have choices, and they like those choices. And you have, you know, different type of housing now, different styles, different architects, and also different areas. You know, we were very concentrated in what we used to call our Gold Coast, you know, that was, let's say, Fifth Avenue, Park Avenue, Madison, or Central Park West. But now it's very trendy to go downtown. It's very, there is a whole area on the west side. It's called the Hudson Yards that is going to get redeveloped. It used to be mainly commercial, and it was rezoned years ago to residential. So now you're going to get new buildings. So definitely there is more expansion, but you have to remember that Manhattan is an island. So we do have water, you know, around us. But even though, you know, you have buildings that are being demolished and new buildings are being built. So definitely we have more choices.
Yeah. Do you think, we talked briefly, and you mentioned the interest, I mean, I believe, you know, my primary business is financing, so I deal with this every single day. The thought was in the first or second quarter we might see interest rates come up, and now there's a good chance that we're going to see interest rates stay pretty, you know, pretty good through the at least the first several quarters. We might see some increase towards the end of the year. There's obviously been a different look at that recently with what's been going on in the economic marketplace. What would you see if rates when rates, it's just a matter of time, whether it's, you know, 6 months from now or a year from now, if rates were to go up, just say a half a percent or so, do you see that having an effect at all on any of the segments of the marketplace?
Yes. I mean, definitely, you know, the interest rates will affect the market. Any, I would say the mid-range market, anywhere between, you know, the 600,000 all the way to the 3 million. I mean, that's a market that is more sensitive to changes in the interest rate because people are looking basically at their monthly expenses. So right now, that's why we're still seeing activity in that segment because the interest rates are still low. But if that were to change, we will see a change in that market as well.
Got it. And what about the economic and demographic factors? I mean, there's a lot of talk out here about the millennials and, you know, the big shift from the baby boomers. And what I think what I'll do is I'll pose this question to you, Jackie, but we're going to have to take a break. When we come back, you could answer. But so the economic factors in terms of the, you know, we hear a lot about the millennials and we're coming out of the baby boomers where they had really the driving power. And now that shift is taking place. We're seeing a lot of transformation of wealth. So when we come back, I want to have you address those issues and talk a little bit more. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. If you have any questions about the New York market or any Jacky Teplitzky, she is a real estate expert in the New York market and really general excellent research overall in the U.S. market. And we're going to talk a little bit now. We've discussed 2015, 16. We've also discussed a little bit about buying behaviors, some of the demographic and factors influence some of the purchasing and buying going on. And now I want to talk a little bit, ask Jackie a little bit about the U.S., kind of the top U.S. and global markets to watch for in 2016. What are your thoughts on, where do you see as the top U.S. and global markets in 2016, Jackie?
Well, I still, you know, the top markets, I think, will continue being New York, Miami, Los Angeles, San Francisco. Those are the main hubs that are also influenced by the foreign market. So the foreign market mainly, you know, prefers those cities. And what we are seeing is because of financial and political problems that countries in Latin America are having, especially like Brazil. So you're seeing a lot of flight capital coming into the U.S. And, you know, we are still seeing from the Far East, from China, you know, money coming in to the West Coast, but that money is also arriving now to Miami and to New York. So, you know, even though that we complain about the U.S., but when people from people that look at us from overseas, we are a much, much more stable economy
So, yeah, so there's still it's still a desirability for people all over the place, really, to buy in the U.S. You had mentioned the New York market, Miami, Southern California, and L.A., you know, San Francisco. There's something about, I don't know if it's just a coincidence, there must be something about, too, the coastal areas that attract a lot of attention from foreign buyers as well.
Yes, absolutely. You know, we have to remember that, you know, people live in cities. People are also doing the same, you know, now that it's a global economy. So people are doing a lot of their homework. There is actually an interesting study, you know, from Knight Frank. Knight Frank is an international company based out of London. And basically they were saying that, you know, they did the research between now and 2025, what will be the trends. And basically, you know, as far as the global ultra net worth, high net worth buyer, where are they going to buy? And it's between London and New York. So that's like the very, you know, high end of the market. There is a very interesting report that they put together every year. So, you know, some years London is number one, some years New York is number one. So it depends on the mood and the, and the taxation. The taxation, you know, law also affects a lot of what's happening in real estate.
Good point. Well, what do you see? We had a couple minutes left in this segment. What do you see in the luxury sector this year and kind of in the near future? You know, to me, it seems like, Jackie, that now with the amount of wealth, it's more of a lifestyle, you know, for these people when they buy. It's almost like a collection. You know, I'll have a home in New York and a place in Pebble Beach and a place in San Francisco and a place in Tokyo and a place in you know, how do you see the luxury market?
Well, I completely agree with you. I mean, real estate is a collector's item. So the same way that people buy art, people buy, and actually in that same, you know, Knight Frank report that I was discussing, you know, they were talking about real estate, wine, art, cars, and watches. Those are the five categories. So I think that people are looking for also being part of a club. So that's another thing. They are buying in buildings where they will find other people like them in those buildings. And they are buying into, you know, big architects' names. That's why, you know, all these developers are trying to, you know, lure buyers also by attaching to their buildings a very well-known architect. And people are looking for amenities. That's the other thing. Everything has to be included, you know, wherever they are. So they don't want to bother. They don't want to have to look for housekeeping or for room service or for anything. They want everything to be reachable and very, very easy. So they don't want the maintenance. And that's why a lot of people are, you know, leaving the houses and going into high rises. Because they just want to simplify their lives, and they want to be able to, you know, from their iPhone, from if they are in Brazil, China, Russia, to be able to, you know, set the temperature in their apartment in New York or San Francisco to the right temperature, so when they arrive, they everything is ready to go for them.
Yeah, well said. I think the we're going to take a break here in another minute, but. The what you'd mentioned just got me thinking, too, is that there seems to be that trend, not only convenience, but close to everything. I think there's also a conscious effort, it seems like, especially on the younger generation. They want to do what's more responsible for not only the economy, but kind of for the a global trying to be more green, don't you think, as well?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, they, you know, they ask about, you know, the air conditioning system or the air system, you know, in the buildings, and they want to be, you know, more conscious about that. That absolutely.
Right.
But I want to say that does not replace, you know, if they are going to buy in a building because, you know, the building have, you know, the apartments have direct park views, or they can basically dial a number and get a massage. So that's still more
right.
important.
Yeah, I agree. All right, we're going to take our last break. When we come back, we're going to finish up with Jackie. If you have any questions, give us a call or you can text 408-838-906.
I'm .com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit RERadioLive.com. That's RERadio.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Thank you again for joining us this afternoon as we wind down the show. Our last segment here, just a few minutes left. If you have any questions for Jackie, she is calling from New York. Real estate expert talking about the New York market and much, much more. You could reach us 408-838-9060. Jackie, we did get a question via text here, and the question was, I think we kind of covered it, but was the New York, kind of the top New York, I guess what they're saying is the top New York housing market. So I'm guessing, is there specific areas that are more expensive? If maybe you could give us kind of an overview of or a breakdown of the New York market in general.
Oh, yes, absolutely. So our Gold Coast that I mentioned earlier in the show are still the areas just around Central Park. So
okay.
We're talking about Central Park South. We're talking about Central Park West, Fifth Avenue, and Park Avenue. That's one area.
Mm-hmm.
But the area that is also very trendy and very popular among the younger population, but the young affluent population, is downtown. So anything, I would say, you know, below 25th Street. So we're talking about Tribeca, Soho. All that area is right now, you know, on the expensive side. West Village, of course.
Got it. Okay. Very good. What, with a couple minutes left here, so tell us a little about a couple of the most expensive places listed in New York.
Well, I have to think about that because every day we get somebody else topping something else, correct? So,
yeah.
You know, we have buildings like 432 Park, you know, with $90 million.
Wow. $90 million?
90, yes, 90. Wow. And a lot of zeros. exactly. We have, there is a rumor that there's something around $120 million is going to come to the market as well.
Wow.
So I think that there is a competition about, you know, who is going to put the highest, you know, price tag,
mm-hmm.
and, of course, who is going also to build higher and taller, you know, and more luxurious.
Yeah. Well, before I let you go, I could not help, but I got to ask you about Donald Trump. So what's your take, or do you want to stay away from that comment, or one way or another? How does New York City feel and see about, are you all jumping up and down rooting for Donald?
Well, I would say that we are all surprised in the real estate community,
uh-huh.
but, you know, he's a very, very good business person. He's definitely
yep.
the best marketing person in real estate that we have ever had.
Hmm. Interesting. Good, strong words. That's good. Well, we'll see how that plays out for sure. I know he's a big, big presence there in the New York area for sure. But before we go, Jackie, I want to make sure for those listening or checking out, where is a good place where they could follow you or find out more information about you and what you do?
Well, first of all, on my Facebook, whoever wants to be on my Facebook, I always
mm-hmm.
I try not to be... you know, to do an oversell. I only put things that are very relevant to the market. So Jacky Teplitzky,
mm-hmm.
very easy. If you want to ask me questions through our website, which is Elliman.com/JACKY, and over there you can also see my email and my cell phone number.
Very good. Well, Jackie, I want to thank you for the time, and maybe I think it might be a good idea if we could have you back maybe, you know, in April after the first quarter is wrapped up and we kind of see, maybe figure out, get a little update of what's going on, and be nice to have you back and talk a little bit about the market at that point. How's that?
April is my preferred month because it's when I was born, so great.
Wonderful. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you so much for your time, Jackie. I really appreciate it. Have a great evening, and we'll chat with you here in a couple months.
Thank you very much for having me.
You're welcome. My pleasure. All right. We're going to have to duck out. Joe Cucchiara, with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you, Jacky Teplitzky. She did a great job today. If you want more information, go to reradiolive.com, download the podcast.